Paul, we'll try this again later. Casey, could you stay on stage, please?
This audition is really interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
What do you think? I need a job.
In the chorus?
Oh, look, Zach, I'd love a part, of course, but I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Casey.
Too good? I did a couple of dance parts, so what?
You were featured. You stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
I can't get a job, Zach. God, you sound like all my friends, my fans, acting like I'm a huge star and don't know it, when the truth is I never even came close. No one had the guts to tell me. Well, it'd be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So, you're going through a slow period. Happens to everyone. Something will happen.
That's what I kept telling myself. Kept telling myself that and telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposed to be this actor. Well, didn't take me long to find out I can't act. Didn't take Hollywood long either.
You didn't work out there?
Oh, sure. A so-so part in a rotten film. Part ended up getting cut, thank God. I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Let's see. Oh yeah, commercials. I almost got to squeeze a roll of toilet paper, but I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business and I end up flunking toilet paper squeezing. I was a dancing band-aid. That was fun. We had an earthquake. I got a terrific tan and you must have heard about.
Yeah, I heard you're going out with some big agent, carrying on, running around, being a bit wild.
Well, when you're a man of leisure, what else is there to do but run around and get a bit wild, besides getting fat and going crazy? Which is why I came back. Dear Zach, little pussycat, I need a job. To have something that I can believe in. To have someone to be. Use me, choose me.
Just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Casey.
Why not?
Look, if you need some money, contact my business manager.
Sure, I need money, who doesn't? But I don't need a handout, I need a job. I need a job and I don't know any other way to say it. Do you want me to say it again?
No.
Fine. We got that far. Look, I haven't worked in 2 years. Not really. There's nothing left for me to do. So I'm putting myself on the line. Yes, I'm putting myself on your line. I don't want to wait on tables. And what I really don't want to do is to teach other people what I should be doing myself. God! I'm a dancer. A dancer dances. Give me somebody to dance with. Give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin. Play me the music. Give me a chance to come through. All I ever needed was the music and the mirror and the chance to dance for you. Give me a job and you instantly get me involved. If you give me a job, then the rest of the crap will get solved. Put me to work, you would think that by now I'm allowed. How do you proud? Throw me a rope to grab onto. Help me to prove that I'm strong. Give me a chance to look forward to saying, hey, listen, they're playing my song. Play me the music. Give me a chance to come through. All I ever needed was the music and the mirror and the chance to dance. Play me the music. Give me a chance to come through. All I ever needed was the music and the mirror and the chance to
you can't go back to the chorus, Casey. That's not the answer.
I'm not trying to go back. I'm trying to start over. I'll settle for that. Starting over.
Starting over. We can't.
What? We? You're talking about us?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're talking about us.
No, Casey, let's just keep this business, okay?
By all means. Who's here for anything else? Isn't that what it's all about, Zach? Work. That's why I'm here today. About work.
Well, you shouldn't have come. You don't fit in. You don't dance like
but
anybody
I did it.
Else.
I
you
did it. Don't. I did it years ago, and I can do it again. Please. You're not even giving me a chance. Just let me try.
Excuse me?
Yes?
Should I let the kids back in?
No. Take the kids down into the basement and teach them the lyrics to that number. Okay? And Larry, send Paul back in, please. All right. Go with Larry and learn the lyrics.
Thank you.
You wanted to see me?
Yes, Paul. I really like the way you dance. No, I mean it. So I figured we'd try this again, okay? For one thing, if you're gonna change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican name to an Italian name?
Because I don't look it. Everyone always says, you don't look Puerto Rican, you don't look Puerto Rican. But I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No. I just wanted to be someone new, so I became Paul San Marco.
Why did you want to become someone new?
Why? Not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? But that's what the word means, Paul. Past.
That's easy for you to say, but...
Look, wait a minute. What made you start dancing? Your parents?
No, what do Puerto Ricans know about theater? I mean, now they have Channel 47, but back then they didn't have anything. But my dad loved movies, and he used to take us all the time. He worked nights, and he'd come home and take us to 42nd Street, and we'd come out of one movie and go into another and another movie. I don't know why, but I always loved musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
Well, I used to sit down front because I couldn't see. I wear contact lenses now. I used to sit down front, and these strange men would come and sit beside me and play with me. I never told anyone because I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter? Look, Paul. If this is too rough for you, I have your picture, I have your resume.
No, no. Okay. From seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around on the street and I'd get caught all the time. It was embarrassing. I was always being Sid Charisse. Always, which I don't really understand because I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. Once, my cousin said to me, you'll never be an actor. And I know she was only telling me this because I'm such a sissy. I mean, I'm terribly effeminate. I always knew I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me is that I didn't know how to be a boy. One day, I looked at myself in the mirror and said, you're 14 years old and you're a faggot. What are you going to do with your life? By that time, I was at Cardinal Hayes High School. There were 3,000 other boys there. I had no protection anymore, no homeroom where I could be charming and funny with the tough boys so they'd fight my battles for me, like when I went to small schools. I really liked school, but my grades got so bad. Even if I knew the answers to questions, I wouldn't put up my hand because I'd be afraid they'd laugh at me. Jesus, they'd even whistle at me in the halls. It was awful, just awful. Finally, I went down to the principal's office and said, I'm a homosexual. Well, it was a Catholic high school, and at the age of 15, you just didn't say that. So he said, would you like to see a psychologist? And I did. And he said, I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and you should quit school. So I did. I really didn't want to. I couldn't take it anymore. See, when I quit school, What I was doing was trying to find who I was and how to be a man. You know, there's a lot of people in this world that don't know how to be men, but since then I found out that I am one. I was looking for the wrong thing. I was trying to learn how to be butch. Anyway, I started hanging around 72nd Street, meeting all these really strange people, just trying to make friends that were like me, so that I could understand what it was that I was. Somebody told me they were looking for male dancers at the Jewel Box Revue, you know, the drag show. So I go down to audition. Now, from all those years of pretending I was Sid Charisse, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything my first audition. And they said to me, "You're too skinny to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony?" And I said, "What's that?" And they said, "A girl. What do I have to do?" "Show us your legs." "I have hair on my legs." "That's okay, come on upstairs." So I went. And they hiked up my dungarees, and they put on a pair of nylon stockings and high heels. It was freaky. It was incredible. And then they brought me back downstairs, and they said, "Oh, you have wonderful legs." And I said, "Really? Terrific." It's so strange thinking about all this. I mean, it was a lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Anyway, then there was this thing of me trying to hide it from my parents. That was something. Because I had to buy all this stuff, like shoes to rehearse in, earrings, makeup. I'd hide it all. My mother would find it. I told her there was a girl in the show that didn't want her mother to know what she was doing, so I was holding her stuff for her. She believed me. I was finally in show business. Was the asshole of show business, but it was a job, nothing to brag about. I had friends. But after a while, it became so demeaning. Nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity, and most of them were ashamed of themselves and considered themselves freaks. I don't know. I guess it was the lack of dignity that got to me, because I left. I muddled around for a while, an office boy, a waiter, but without an education, you can't get a job. So when the Jewel Box called and asked if I'd come back, I went. We were at the Apollo Theater on 125th Street, doing 4 shows a day with a movie. It was really tacky. The show was going to go to Chicago, and my parents wanted to say goodbye. They were going to bring my luggage to the theater after the show. We were doing this Oriental number, and I looked like Anime Wong. I had these 2 great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head and this huge headdress with gold balls all over it. I was going on for the finale and going down the stairs, and who should I see standing by the stage door? My parents. They got there too early. Freaked. Didn't know what to do. I thought to myself, I know. I'll just take a deep breath and head quickly down the stairs like everyone else, and they'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath, and I started going down the stairs, and just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, "Oh my God." Well, I died. But what could I do? I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going, and after the show, I went up to my dressing room, and after I'd finished getting dressed and taking off my makeup, I went back downstairs, and there they were, standing in the middle of all of these. And the only thing they said to me was, "Please write, make sure you eat, and take care of yourself." And just before my parents left, my dad turned to the producer and said, "Please take care of my son." That was the first time he'd ever called me that. And I'm sorry.
Zach, are you ready for them?
Yeah, bring him in.
Nobody should draw my eye. You are the backup to the star. You are her frame. So that means arms, legs, body, everything is together. All right, reviewing starting position. Starting in third position. Shoulder square. Eyes up. 5, 6. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Step, step. Singular sensation, and
singular sensation, every little step she takes.
Click.
One
drink.
Thrilling combination, every move that she makes. One smile and suddenly nobody else will do.
But
you know you'll never be lonely with you.
You're
the girl is second best to Nelson. Blue sign, giving your attention to
Rush.
I really have to mention she's the one.
Alright, the whole combination facing front.
Wait, Larry,
yeah.
The brushes, the kicks were brushed, right?
And when does the hat go up?
Hat goes up on two.
Listen. Now listen. Larry has the exact look that I'm looking for. Very 30s, right? So eyes on him. Let's do it again.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2.
Shoulder up.
Singular sensation.
Stay pulled up. Point. Point.
Flick.
Step. Kick.
Hat to the head.
3, 4.
Hand on the hip. Follow through. Up, down.
Fill the phrase.
Elbow right.
Down, point.
Step, brush.
3, 4.
Suddenly nobody.
Step, flick. Step, and step.
Lunge.
Slow.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Hat.
Kick. Step, brush.
Palm up.
Lift,
lift, lift, change, step,
and
step,
and
change, and step,
across,
back, present, and down, right, down, chest, down, point, down, chest, body, right, back, back, body, back, step, up, down to the head, side, side, step, up, shoulder, up, plie, the hat, 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 plie,
the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the hat, plie, the
hat, plie, the hat, let's form a line. Tallest in the center, shortest on the ends. Larry, you count them in.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1.
Casey, you're late.
Singular sensation, every little step she takes.
Maggie, make it sharp.
1. Thrilling combination, every move that she makes.
Eyes front, Val.
1 smile and suddenly nobody else will do.
Lead on the turn, Casey.
You know you'll never be lonely with you know who. 1 moment in her presence and you can forget the rest.
Late again, Casey.
for the girl is second best.
Pull him in.
To none
side. You're distorting the combination, Casey.
Side, give her your attention. Do I really have to mention she's the one?
What's wrong? What are you doing?
My job.
What?
How can you do it? You got out of the chorus when you were 22. What the hell makes you think you can go back now?
My sanity.
Casey, you can't do it.
But I did it. I did what you wanted. I cooled it, I pulled it in. I danced like everybody else.
Yeah, I know. And to be perfectly honest, I couldn't stand it. I'm gonna
take the lead. You know what? That's your problem. Why? Because you took me out of the chorus in the first place. Does that make you feel like some kind of failure?
Why did you leave me?
So we're gonna get into that.
Why did you leave me? I came home one night and you were gone.
Why, Zach? You noticed.
Yeah, very funny.
You had already left me weeks before.
Left? I thought we were living together.
No. Sharing an apartment, maybe. No, I mean in the real sense of the word, left. You left. You were madly in love again.
Oh, I wasn't. You know I wasn't. I was directing my first play.
And you were in love with it, and often the only world that means anything to you.
You know how important that play was to me. Christ, if I could direct my first straight play and get away with it, it meant I wouldn't be stuck making up dance moves for the rest of my life.
You were never gonna be stuck. You were gonna make sure you did it all. Direct, choreograph, musicals, plays, movies. I know you liked work, but you really get off on it, don't you?
Yeah, I guess I do. You didn't seem to mind when we were working together. It was only when
Zach,
we worked.
I didn't mind not being part of your work. I loved you. I could handle that. It was not being part of your life that really got to me, and not being able to keep up to you because that's what you expected. I know you did. You were moving up, and you wanted me to be right up there with you.
Yeah.
Well, I was a good dancer, but you wanted me to be a star.
What's wrong with that? Why shouldn't you be? Why shouldn't you be the best that you can possibly be? When I got out of the chorus, I decided
that's
that I was
That's not a decision! It's a disease! God, good, better, best! I hate it! I can't stand it! Are you gonna go from one show to the next, rehearsing them all 24 hours a day for the rest of your life? You know what? You're not even doing it for yourself. It's like you're trying to prove something. Like I was. Please you. Keep you. Get you back. I don't want to prove anything anymore, Zach. I just want to do what I love as much as I can for as long as I can, and at least now I'm doing it for myself. Who are you doing it for? I'm sorry. I've no right to judge. God, why are we doing this? We must be over this by now.
I am.
Good. Then I don't feel like you owe me any favors. Just treat me like everybody else.
Is that what you really want from me?
Yes.
Is this what you really want to do?
Yes. I'd be proud to be one of them.
Yeah.
They're wonderful.
Yeah, but you're special.
No, Zach. We're all special. She's special, and he's special, and Sheila, and Ritchie, and Connie. They're all special. God. I'd be happy to be dancing in that chorus. I'll take it, if you'll take me.
I don't really know. How about might we match them up in combinations and we'll do the tap routine.
Sounds good. Everybody on stage reviewing the tap number. As we're doing this, I want to see the smiles, not those dancer side of smiles, but those I love to dance smiles, all right? Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Stage right, everybody, please.
Paul, get up, Paul.
What are you doing? I was just...
Paul, are you okay? Did you hurt yourself? Did you pull a muscle? Is it your ankle?
It's not your knee again, is it?
Old injury?
Yeah, he had it operated on last year. It's his cartilage.
Call a doctor. Shit.
No.
Just stand back. Everyone,
no,
please.
Call a doctor. Sydney Rhodes, 797-2679. Put something under his knee.
Does anyone... Give me a dance bike, please.
No, it's fine. I think I just twisted my ankle.
Just relax. Okay. Easy, ready.
One, two,
up.
All right, I.
Does anyone have a Darvin or a Valium?
I do.
Give me some water.
I'll grab some.
You're gonna be okay, Paul.
Yeah, but out of a job, huh?
Look, I don't think you should give him that. You don't know what's wrong.
Please, I've already had three today.
Thank you.
Zach, the doctor said that it's going to be faster if we meet up at the hospital than if the ambulance came here. We should call him a cab.
All right.
I'll go.
No.
I'll help.
Fine. Okay, count of three. Hang in there. One. Got it. Two. Three.
Breathe.
Where's his dance bag?
Which one's his?
It's the red.
Paul, I'll see you later. Okay? Get easy. Larry. Call me from the hospital?
Yeah.
It's easy, nice.
What do you do when you can't dance anymore?
Kill yourself?
No, really.
Oh shit, what kind of a question is that?
That's really deep.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. What do you do?
Well, I'll tell you. Because I'm getting scared. You know, one day you say to yourself, hey Ritchie, you've been having fun for almost 8 years now, and where's it getting you?
A lot of people are feeling that way. They're getting out of the business fast.
There's no security in dancing.
Well, wait a second, Ritchie.
No, there's no promotion and there's no advancement.
Yeah, but if you're looking for that kind of security, then just forget it.
Well, it's not just that.
What is it, then?
I mean, shit, I could do without that, but there's no work anymore.
It's true, but isn't that true for everyone?
Please, I don't want to hear about how Broadway's dying because I just got here.
Oh, don't worry, honey, it isn't.
But even if they were, even if you did book this show, it's gonna close someday. Nothing lasts forever, right?
Yeah, but that's just the way it is.
No, he's right.
You know, the only chorus line you can actually depend on is the one in unemployment.
Look, that's unfair.
Well, don't you want to do more than just dance in the chorus?
Gee, I just want to get in one.
Well, I want to be something more than just the short, skinny blonde girl second from the end. Not that I want to be a star or anything.
Hell, I do.
Everyone in the goddamn country wants to be a star. All right, I admit it. I want to be the next Gwen Verdon.
Oh, but she dances.
I know. Don't you just love her?
But I want to know what you're going to do if you weren't going to dance anymore.
Oh, who cares? I mean, I don't care if I never dance another step again. I'd be happy just going to Hollywood and replacing Jill St. John. Big fucking deal, right?
Well, I can dream, can I?
Yeah, but dreams don't pay the rent.
So? I'll find someone who can.
Yeah, that's the thing. A girl can always get married.
She never said anything about marriage.
And another thing is...
Please, I don't think I can take it.
These bodies don't last forever.
I can't take it!
We're no better off than athletes.
I'm sorry, but I just can't worry about any of this right now. I plan to go on kicking these feet as long as I can, and when I can't, well, then I'll just find something else.
What? Right, so you get into acting. No, you'll love it. I mean, That's what I'm into. Not very good, but I'm getting better. And believe me, honey, it beats busting your ass dancing any day. And at least when you're an actor, you stand a chance.
Come on, there's more actors that have worked than dancers.
Yeah. Right? Oh, shit, but that's just theater. Look, none of us got into this business to play it safe. We're all here because we wanted to be. You're all just treating it like it's another job, and it's not. So what are you all talking about?
Life. Darling, it's tough all over. That's why I have no plans, no alternatives. Just get me through the day. One day at a time is enough for me.
Listen, we all feel the same way or we wouldn't be here. I got a wife and two kids, and as much as I love dancing and theater, it's all about paying the bills now and getting the kids through school. I mean, I have to go where the money is.
What are you gonna do?
I'd like to stay in the business, maybe stage managing, someday directing.
Hello. Oh my God.
Whatever, I'll see.
Oh, I can't think of anything else I'd do.
I mean, what if we all had to choose a career? Go on, pick a career. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Younger. Well, I know what I'm gonna do. Because I know one night whatever show I'm in is gonna close, and then I'm finally gonna be able to get off my diet. And then me and my husband are gonna go up to our 50 acres in Vermont, have a bunch of kids, dance around the kitchen cooking, and enjoy getting fat.
I wouldn't mind that. Well, except the fat part. You know, I'm not quite ready yet, but maybe one day?
Listen, all I want is just to be happy.
Oh, come on, but aren't you happy? Look, I sit around and get depressed and worry about these things all the time, too. But then I meet someone, and they say to me, "Wow, you dance on Broadway. How fabulous. You made it. You're something." And Christ, I get this feeling because I remember when I used to stand outside of the stage door and watch the girls leaving with their makeup and their eyelashes. And I would think, God, I will never be that old. I will never be that old. I will never be old enough to come out of that stage door. But deep down, I knew that I would. God damn it, I have made it this far. I'm not giving up now.
That's what I used to say. I'll never give up. I've got to be a dancer by the time I'm 18. And then I decided, well, maybe I should be a musical comedy, but I've got to be playing parts until I'm 21.
Oh no, you did that too? You gave yourself a time limit?
I still do it.
Right, and then you're 25, and you say, just a few years more, well, hell, I'm 30 now. How long do I have left to be a chorus cutie? 3, 4, maybe, if I get my eyes done. I don't know. Lately, I haven't been wanting to deal on that level anymore. Been thinking about opening up a dance studio. Am I growing up? Am I copping out? I don't know.
But who does? Who knows anything? I think this is just something we're gonna have to wait and see.
Nah, but if today were the day that you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
Kiss today goodbye. The sweetness and the sorrow. Wish me luck the same to you, but I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for love. Look, my eyes are dry. The gift was ours to borrow. It's as if we always knew, but I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for love. Kiss today.
say goodbye and point me towards tomorrow. We did what we had to do.
Before I start eliminating, I just wanted to say, I think you're all terrific. You've all been wonderful about going through all of this today. And I sincerely wish I could hire each and every one of you. But I can't. Dawn. Greg, Al, Kristine, Bebe, Sheila, Connie, and Maggie. I'm sorry. Thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. As for the rest of you, congratulations. Rehearsals will begin September 22nd. We will rehearse for 6 weeks with a 3-month out-of-town tryout. Our show will go up sometime mid-January. You will be required to sign a standard minimum contract with a 6-month rider. You'll be contacted as to when and where to sign your contracts. And I just want to say, I am really glad that we're all going to be working together. Ladies and gentlemen, your chorus line.
Every move that he makes.
suddenly nobody else will do. You know you'll never be lonely with you know who one. Moment in his presence, and you can forget the rest. For the guy is second best to none. Do I really have to mention she's the one? She walks into a room and you know
she's uncommonly rare, very unique, peripatetic, poetic, and chic.
She walks into a room and you know
her mind and poise are from this world.
She's a special girl strolling. Can't help all of her qualities extolling. Loaded with charisma is but gently, subtly, gentle, and chiller. She walks into a room and you know
you must
shuffle along, join the parade. She's the quintessence of making a grave. This is what you call traveling. Oh, strut yourself. Can't get enough of her. Love her. I'm a son of a gun. She is one of a kind. Do I really have to mention she's